Perry. This is Perry Gilbert. I have to recognize Perry Gilbert because he is fabulous in our sound booth and just cued me because our microphone wasn't on. Perry, yeah, round of applause for Perry. Absolutely. He deserves it. Perry, I can't believe I didn't realize the microphone was on, so thank you very much. You can hear me better now, right? Yeah. All right, so I was saying about the uniform. Again, reminder, names and fleeces. I'm going to stick to this little campaign of mine because I'm always finding fleeces and it doesn't have a name in it and then I don't know who it belongs to. And I know your parents invest in these fleeces and it's very important that we get them back to you when they're left somewhere. So please put your names in all of your outerwear, right? So they can always be returned. Also a reminder, in lower school, we don't wear UGG boots. We can only wear those in middle school. It's a special middle school privilege. So when you get to be a 6th, 7th, and 8th grader, you can wear the UGG boots. But for now, in lower school, we're just wearing sneakers. When it gets to be really cold, if you want to bring in boots for recess, you can. But for now, sneakers really do a great job in keeping us warm, and we can really move around well in those sneakers, right? Yeah, okay. So I asked my friend Zoe to maybe come up here on stage and help me with something. Zoe, do you remember? Will you come up with me? Need a hand? Good job. Does everybody know Zoe? You say good morning, Zoe? So Zoe always greets me when I see her. Right, Zoe? So one of the things that is big for me and for your teachers and everyone here at Montgomery is when we see each other, we greet each other. But I'm going to show you how Zoe takes it even one step further that I want us all to practice. So I might pass Zoe, and Zoe, what do you say to me?
Hi, Miss Marotta.
Hi, Zoe. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm great. Thanks, Zoe. Zoe always extends that greeting. Did you hear what she did? She said hello to me. She said my name. That's so important with our good manners. We all know each other's names at Montgomery School. I love that about our school, that I know all of your names. Mr. McManus knows all of your names. I see Mr. Coco over here. He knows all of your names. Mrs. Hoover, Mrs. Dadalo, we all know each other's names, and we greet you with your name. So when you say good morning, let's include the name. If the person greets you with a how are you today, you say fine, or maybe not so good. How are you? Ask the question back. Can we all practice that like Zoe did? Great job for Zoe. Thanks, Zoe. Thanks for helping me. Okay, so this morning's chapel, we have our fabulous, who do you see over here? Mrs. Hoover, oh my gosh, let's just take a minute. Everyone, kindergarten, look around the room at the beautiful artwork. Oh my gosh. Do you think it's easy to hang this artwork up? Do you ever see artwork on our walls for very long? It's always changing, right? Mrs. Hoover spends so much of her free time, and I say free time in air quotes because teachers really don't have free time. Their free time, they are looking at emails, they're answering phone calls. Mrs. Hoover is hanging up work. It's a big job, and she's out here with a ruler. She's getting everything straight. It's not easy just to put these things up so straight and spaced so nicely. It's like a gallery in here between Miss Naur and Mrs. Hoover. So I think that she's pretty fabulous. Do you think she's pretty fabulous? What do you love about going to art? Does anyone want to share in kindergarten? Sophia, what do you love? You like art. That sums it up really nicely. Chase? You like clay? You like playing in art? You like playing with the materials, excuse me, that she provides for you? Good one. Amber, what do you like? You like what? You like art. We have a lot saying that. Sophia, what do you like about art? I like creating things and coloring. Great answer. What do you like? Go ahead, Sully. I like painting, Riley. I like clay. Zoe. I like molding. Molding things with the clay. Good one. Michael. You like art. How many of you love art? I know I do too. When I have a free moment, I love coming in and watching you create. And Mrs. Hoover is so intentional about the way she teaches you and builds on your skills each year. So by the time you get to middle school, the things that you know because of the knowledge that she's given you is beyond fabulous. And I know we're going to welcome her when she comes onto the stage to deliver her chapel message. So let's welcome Mrs. Hoover.
Thank you, Mrs. Murata. And hello, everyone. Hello, my amazing artists. How are you today? You ready to create? Yes, that's wonderful. That's so amazing. That makes me feel so thankful to be here with you, to be able to teach you, and to be able to watch you to create. It makes me thankful every single day. And we're going to be thinking about that big word. You see this word up here? It says thankful. Thinking about what does that mean and how are we thankful, how we can be thankful, and what we are thankful for. And to me, being thankful means that you're thinking about, I'm thinking about what or who makes me happy, what or who helps me in my life, and what or who makes me feel good. And I want to know a little bit about what you are thankful for. Does anybody have anything? I think you're probably thinking about this right now, maybe in class or with your family. Mishi, what are you thankful for? Can you say a little louder? Your family? Me too. Chase, what are you thankful for? Your dog. Michael, what about you?
I'm thankful
for your fish. Our pets are very important. Benjamin, what are you thankful for? Your dog, yep. Miles, what do you think? Who has a pet that they're thankful for? I know I do. We have a few. Uh-huh. If you don't have a pet, does anybody have like a special stuffed animal that they're thankful for? I do. Who else wants to share? Let's take two more. Zoe, what are you thankful for? Nice. How about you, Rhea? A bear made out of candy. Wow, that seems like something to be really thankful for. So something else that I'm thankful for, or someone else that I'm thankful for, is this author and illustrator. His name is Todd Parr, and he writes fantastic children's books that are fun, but they're also really meaningful. And I'm going to share with you his book today. It's called The Thankful Book, because we're thinking about being thankful. And I'll do my best to keep up with my slides as I read through this. So, The Thankful Book. Amber, did you want to say one thing before I start my book? Go ahead. I'm thankful for you too, Amber. That was so sweet. Thank you. All right. Every day, I try to think about the things that I am thankful for. So let's see if we're thankful for some of the same things that Todd Parr is thankful for. Let's see. I am thankful for my hair because it makes me unique. I am thankful for my ears because they let me hear words like, I love you. Is that little birdie saying tweet, tweet? Telling the elephant, I love you. I am thankful for my garden because I like to watch things grow. I am thankful for my shadow because it makes me look taller. Me too. I am thankful for bubble baths because they keep me squeaky clean. I am thankful for underwear because I like to wear it on my head. Oh my goodness. Oh my. I am thankful for my friends because they make me smile. What about you? Yeah? Oh, I like what Miss Nebolski is doing. She's doing this. That means me too. If you feel like me too, you can do that. I am thankful for my pets because they keep me warm. I am thankful for vacations because I get to see new people and places. I am thankful for walks because they are special times for just you and me. I am thankful for my hands because they help me give special gifts. I am thankful for my feet because they help me run and play. I am thankful for music because it makes me want to dance. Oh yeah. I am thankful for colors because they make me want to paint. Me too. I am thankful for school because I love to learn new things. I am thankful for the library because it is filled with endless adventures. Wow, this is awesome. I am thankful for healthy food because it keeps me strong. Oh yeah. I am thankful for the fall because I love to jump in the leaves. And I'm thankful for the winter because I like to build snowmen. I am thankful for hugs because they make me feel good. Can you give yourself a hug? That feels good. I am thankful for kisses because they make me feel loved. I am thankful for holidays because they bring my family together. And the pets too. There are lots of things to be thankful for. Try to remember some of them every day. The end. Love, Todd. Were we thankful for some of the same things that Todd is thankful for? I know I was. Can you name one? What's one thing that you are thankful for from this book that you could agree with? Let me see if anybody who hasn't shared yet. Brennan. The what? The pets, yes, that's a big one. What do you think? The paint? Yes, Paris. Yeah, I think you were thankful for most of that book because you were like really going like this. That was awesome. Colton. Yeah, oh, that's a really big one. So what I loved about that book was that he was thankful for some of the big things in our life, like our family and our school, but also some of the little things like our hair and our feet, things that we maybe would not think to be thankful for every day. And I know I am, and I'm trying, but you know what I think is important? Either big or small, you want to think about what you're thankful for, but you also want to say it. Right? Just don't keep it inside. If you're thankful for someone or something, let them know, because that makes them feel really good, because when you're thankful, it makes you feel good. And then when you say thank you to someone else, that makes them feel good. It makes them feel appreciated for what they do. So one thing that I see a lot around here is we have our friends holding doors for us all the time, or our teachers, and they don't really have to do that, but they're doing it to be kind. So that's something that you could be thankful for. One really, really small thing that you could see, oh, they're holding the door for me. I'm going to go ahead and say, thank you. If Sophia was holding the door for me, thanks, Sophia. And that makes them feel appreciated for the job that they're doing. So it's just one way to make someone feel good. You could think about it, wow, that was really cool. I'm really thankful. But if you say it, it's even better. So let's see. I have a couple hands, so I'm going to have you share. And then I have one more thing for us to do. Wesley. For the what? Oh, me too. Clay is the best. Zoe. What is the big word? Oh, which Sophia? I was looking at Sophia Ott. Thank you for having me clarify. But if any of the Sophias were holding the door for me, I would say thank you, Sophia. Yes, Michael. Cool. Anybody else? One last thought. Anybody else? Oh my goodness. You know what? I'm going to have you take that thought and put it in your brain. Screw it on tight. Okay? When you get back to class, maybe you can share some of that in your morning meeting. I think that this book really got you thinking about all the awesome things that we have and all the people that we have around us that make me feel really good, make us feel really good, and make us feel really thankful. So I want to say thank you for listening to me today. Your attention has made me feel really appreciated. And I love that. We did such a good job, kindergarten. And before we go, I have a song that I'd like you to listen to by somebody that I loved when I was a child. His is a singer. His name is Raffi. Does anybody know Raffi? He sings Baby Beluga, Baby Beluga in the Deep Blue Sea. It's not that song, even though that was my favorite. This song is called Thanks a Lot. Oh, here it is. It's called Thanks a Lot. And what's really cool about this video is it combines his song and some art, so we get to watch and listen. Okay? Do I press play? Do you press play? Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for the sun in the sky. Thanks a lot. Thanks for the clouds so high.
This way.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for the whispering wind. Thanks a lot. Thanks for the birds in the spring. Thanks a lot. Thanks for the moonlit night. Thanks a lot. Thanks for the stars so bright. Thanks a lot. Thanks for the wonder in me. Thanks a lot. Thanks for the way I feel. Thanks for the animals, thanks for the land, thanks for the people.